I Thank you. Our starting lineups for this evening.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to High Top Sports Network. I'm Jake DeLuca, bringing you the action here tonight between these two WPIAL Class 3A Section 1 teams, the Kiski Area Cavaliers, playing host here to the Woodland Hills Wolverines. These two teams come in with a section record. Kiski Area 1-0 in their section, winning against Greensburg-Salem. You caught that broadcast here on High Top Sports Network last week. And Woodland Hills coming into this match with an 0-1 record. So last year, the Wolverines, a 3-13 team. Of course, Kiski Area sneaking into the playoffs in that fourth spot in Class 3A Section 1. Just edging out Greensburg-Salem last year, who was 7-9. Kiski Area 8-8 last year, off to a good start, 1-0. They'd like to continue that role here against a Woodland Hills team. So the starters here for Woodland Hills, we have the junior Kayla Walter, number 3. Number 7, Nessa Boyd, she's a senior. Number 10, Sarah Bauer, she's a freshman. Elena Dondo, she's a freshman. Elena Williams, number 22. By the way, Alana Dondo, number 21, but 22. Alana Williams, a senior. Number 27, Sunrise Mayerez, a senior. And number 28, Cynthia Burnham, a junior. As for the Cavaliers, the home team tonight, number 4, Madeline Joyce, a freshman. Number 5, Emma Beck, a senior. Number 6, Madeline Polka, a junior. Number 9, Isabella Ondish, a sophomore. Number 10, Bryn Hewitt, a junior. 11, Cora Coleman, a sophomore. Number 14, Lacey Sopranos, a junior. Number 16, Carly Kuhn, the senior. Number 20, Abigail Johns, a sophomore. Bryn Byers, number 22, a junior, and number 24, Sydney Joyce. As right now, the team's being announced. Woodland Hills already announced. Now they're announcing the seniors down here on the court. If you're just joining us now, the JV team for Kiski Area was able to take down the Wolverines in two straight sets. I'm sure the varsity team would like to do the same, except they play a best of five, so it would take three sets instead of two. JB, of course, a best of three. But these two teams are ready to go out there now, huddling up on their respective sides. Cavaliers, the first ones to break huddle in the first six on the court here. I'm sure we'll have some substitutions, so I'll hold my breath here. But out there now, Carly Kuhn, Kate Wigton out there as well, as Bryn Hewitt, Sydney Joyce, Lacey Sopranos, and trying to see the last number out there, and that of course is Madeline Polka out on the court now for the visiting Wolverines as the libero checks in. The libero, number 7, Nessa Boyd. Trying to see the numbers down there. Number 22 out there, Alana Williams. 27, Sunrise Mayerez. I believe that's number 10, Sarah Bauer. Kayla Walter also out there. And Cynthia Burnham. So those are the six on the court for each side. As right now, Sydney Joyce will get us started from the service line. And that first one just sneaking in. That one rode the line there. You can see a couple of Wolverines players. Oh, no, actually, the officials initially pointing to Kiski, to the Kiski area side, but changing that, and that's the right call. That one looked like it was just an inch or so over the line, and now it'll be the Wolverines with a service error, and back to the service line will be the Cavaliers checking in. The libero, freshman Madeline Joyce for the Cavaliers. Back-to-back nights, we've had these Cavaliers on High Top Sports Network as Joyce's serve makes it over. Hit over there by Burnham. Set by Hewitt and hit across by Carly Kuhn. Cynthia Burnham, or rather Sunrise Mayerez, hits that over. And a push ball there by Sydney Joyce. Received well by Nessa Boyd, popped up and then hit across by Mayerez. Leaping for that hit for Kiski was Coleman. And a nice return that time from Sarah Bauer. Just tipped over that time by Ondish. And a joust in front of the net. The net moved. We're going to see who they give the point to. It'll be awarded to Kiski. So the front row of Woodland Hills, a little eager on that play, getting the net violation. That'll send Madeline Joyce back to the service line. Joyce's serve away. That one long, thinking about going for it there was Nessa Boyd, but she smartly lays off of that one, as now it brings us to another tie early on in this first set. Checking in now is Elena Dondo, the freshman here for the Wolverines, and back to serve, it's Cynthia Burnham. Burnham able to get that across, diving for the dig that time was Madeline Joyce, but unable to pop that ball up, and now Woodland Hills with the lead here. They scored the first point on the long serve by Sydney Joyce, and now back again, Burnham to serve. That one received by Joyce, set by the other Joyce. Back row, received, and then smacked across there by Bauer. Popped up there by Hewitt, Coleman, rather. Receiving that one was Sydney Joyce. Popped up, and now Madeline Joyce hammers that one across. Trying to tip that one over with a little finesse was Alana Williams, but unable to make it over the net with that hit, and that'll give Kiski Area the serve once more. Back to serve this time, the senior outside hitter, Carly Kuhn. Kuhn serve away, that one short and into the net. So a few service errors early on for both of these teams as we have a substitution. I do not have a number 30 on my roster, but number 30 for the Wolverines coming into the game. Back now to serve for Woodland Hills is Sunrise Mayerez. Mayerez's serve across. That one received there by Coleman. And Madeline Joyce trying to get that one over, blocked in front, but the rally continues after the solid play there by the Cavaliers. Saved there by Beck. Popped up by Madeline Joyce and then hit across there by Isabella Ondish. But that one bounces out of bounds. So now the Wolverines with a 2-point lead here in set number one. And once again, back to serve. It'll be Sunrise Mayerez. Received there by Beck. Popped up by Sydney Joyce and then sent across by Madeline Joyce. Players colliding there in the middle row for Woodland Hills. Results in a point for the Cavaliers. And back to serve now, it'll be Bryn Hewitt. The junior defensive specialist slash right side hitter. Serve is across. That one popped off, bouncing awkwardly off the outside of the arm of Helen DeCrosta. So now back tied up here, 5-5 at Kiski Area High School. That serve across by Hewitt. Hit a little too hard there on the receive. That ball goes into the net, then falls down onto the court. So Kiski now with the lead. Yes, that'll send Bryn Hewitt back to the service line. Hewitt serve across, received well, popped up there by Williams, and then sent across. Back to get that one. Beck, three ball, free ball sent over. And that one just hammered a little too hard that time by Dondo, as now Kiski with their largest lead early on here, up by two. Once again, Hewitt to serve. That serve across, and then that time just off the knuckles of DeCrosta. So Hewitt doing well here from the service line. She'll try to keep that streak going here. I believe that is now 4 unanswered points for Kiski. Actually, I believe it's 5. Popped up there by Bauer and then hit across by the libero, Boyd. Set by Joyce, tipped across there by Johns. And nearly able to keep that alive was Woodland Hills, but just a little overextended on the hit there. Leads to another Cavaliers point. And another Hewitt serve. That one across, received there by Bauer, but just mishit there as that ball travels behind her towards the corner of the gym. And yet another point here for Hewitt, and an ace at that, as that forces the Wolverines to take their first time out of the contest. While I have a moment, I just want to say that High Top Sports Network is excited to broadcast Kiski Athletics this fall. If you or someone you know is a local business owner interested in sponsoring High Top Sports Network's coverage of the Cavaliers this season or in the future, please contact us at staff@hightopsportsnetwork.com or by phone at 724-824-3554. You can also find us at www.hightopsportsnetwork.com or on Facebook at High Top Sports and on Twitter at @hightop_sports, as Hewitt serve goes across. And that's 3 hits there for the Wolverines. So these two teams trading points back and forth early on in this set, with Woodland Hills holding a 2-point lead at one point, up 5-3, but now 8 unanswered points here for the Cavaliers, as that ball is going to be another ace for Hewitt. And Hewitt just absolutely carrying the Cavaliers here with the serving so far in this first set. Make it now 9 straight for the Cavaliers. Hewitt back to serve once more. And miss hit again, diving to the floor to try to save that was the freshman Sarah Bauer, but unable to get it back into play was the freshman. So that'll send the ball back to the Cavaliers side, and Hewitt will reapproach the service line. Hewitt serve across, and just the Wolverines having a difficult time here receiving in the back row. And Hewitt continues to target Sunrise Mayerez in the middle of the back row. And she's just had no answers for Hewitt's serve. Once again, that one mishit. And if it ain't broke, don't fix it. Hewitt just attacking the back row of the Wolverines to great success here. Now a 10-point lead opened up for these Cavaliers. Hewitt with another serve. That time Mayerez gets under it. And a killer shot there by number 30. Again, I don't have that number on my roster. I'll do my best to try and find it out here, but a great kill there by her for Woodland Hills. So 12 straight points for Kiski. Now the Wolverines trying to answer. Madeline Joyce receives that one, and then Sydney Joyce sends it over. Received on the other end by Mayerez, popped up. Kept alive, and trying to make the play there was the freshman Madeline Joyce, but just a little outside of her range as that one goes on the outside of the net for another Wolverines point. At the service line, Sarah Bauer, the jump serve. That time finding the weak spot in the defense, and you know, we saw Hewitt go on that string of great serves, including a number of aces during her time at the service line. Now Bauer trying to do the same. Bauer serve across. That one received by Beck. Popped up there and then hit across. Just pushed there by Madeline Joyce. And a free ball sent over by Joyce. Great block in front there by the sophomore, Abigail Johns. As she gets the Cavaliers the ball back here with an 8-point lead. Substitution coming on the court. That's Lacey Sofranos going to be checking in here for Isabella Ondish. And back to serve will be the newly subbed in Sofranos. And free ball sent over there by Boyd. Beck with the receive. Sydney Joyce sets up Johns. Nice dig there by the Wolverines and then sent back across by Boyd. Another set by Sydney Joyce, and that time the kill is good. I believe converting on that one was Kate Wigton for the Cavaliers. And now, once again, it'll be Sofranos from the service line. She gets it across. Two Wolverines get crossed up there, but the ball is still in play. Great job on the front row there by Sydney Joyce. And Kate Wigton as well in on that block. Now a 10-point lead here for Kiski area. Sofranos with the serve. That one mishit by the libero, Nessa Boyd, and that'll be another ace here. Many of those have come for Kiski area in this first set. A trend I'm sure they would like to continue. Sofranos with the serve, gets that across, received there by Mayerez. Great job there by Beck, denying the kill that time from, I believe that was Alana Williams, but that was a power shot there. Great defensive effort by Emma Beck, the senior defensive specialist. And they don't call you a defensive specialist for nothing. Beck really showing off the skills on that last play. A little trickery that time from Alana Williams with the quick deflection over, but the Cavaliers were ready for it. And that'll be four hits for the Wolverines. So now just 4 points away from closing out this first set are the Cavaliers. Sofranos with another serve. That one goes into the net. Kiski area had been on a roll with good serving, but that comes to an end as now it'll be Woodland Hills, and back to serve Elena Dondo, the freshman. Dondo's serve across, and that one hammered out of bounds. That had a lot of zip to it, but just couldn't find the boundaries. As now Kiski area will have another serve. As checking in now is Carly Kuhn for Emma Beck, and also coming in Madeline Polka for Abigail Johns. And that'll send the junior Madeline Polka to the service line. Polka serve across. That one received by Bauer. Popped up by Mayerez and then sent across, just skimming the top of the net by Cynthia Burnham, and that'll give the Wolverines a point and the serve. That one just hammered on the serve from Woodland Hills, and that'll send Sydney Joyce to the service line, the junior setter for the Cavaliers. Joyce's serve across, received by Boyd. And sent across there by Burnham. Set to Burnham, kept alive by Carly Kuhn. Kuhn will get the pass back, going for the kill. Nice diving dig there by Boyd, and then sent across by Burnham. Joyce with the set. Kuhn with the kill. Nice diving effort that time by Sarah Bauer, but not enough as that ball falls to the court. And now we're at set point here as Kiski has a huge lead. It'll be Sydney Joyce here. Joyce's serve across, received by Boyd. Set there by Williams. Received on the other side by Polka. And then a free ball sent over to the Wolverines. Going up for the kill. Nice dig that time by Lacey Sofranos, but an even nicer kill by Alana Williams. Or, excuse me, that's actually Cynthia Burnham who had the kill on the play. So the Wolverines will live to play another volley here. It's now a discussion here by the official on the Woodland hillside. Hit across there by Alana Williams. Joyce with the set. That time it goes to Wigton, and that will be set point. Wigton gives the Cavaliers the win here in set number one. And now Kiski Area celebrates on the court. And we have 60 seconds until the start of set number two. Here again, so happy that you all are joining us here tonight on High Top Sports Network. I'm Jake DeLuca, bringing you the action here tonight. And while I have a second, I want to tell you all about one of our great sponsors here, Arms Care, located at 85 Blade Drive in Katanning. They provide the highest quality medical equipment, supplies, and service for use in your home. After an accident, illness, or surgery, the caring professionals at Arms Care can assist you in getting the appropriate medical equipment into your home where you can make the most progress on your recovery. Arms Care offers 24/7 emergency service, as well as a wide variety of specialized medical equipment. And their expertise staff is committed to helping you or your loved one regain normalcy by providing the highest level of quality home care equipment, supplies, and service. Contact Arms Care at 724-545-3200 today. So as we get ready for set number two, the clock operator tricked me. I thought that there was 60 seconds to go. Now we got an extra 2 minutes. The clock now winding down to a minute 23. But yeah, Kiski with a very dominant first set victory, winning 25-11. Sure, they will be looking for more of that success here in set number two. Yeah, but yesterday, you know, we watched these Kiski Area Cavaliers play the first ever sanctioned high school girls volleyball game on a grass field. The Ellen Toy grass court at Kennedy Park, newly minted. Just a beautiful, beautiful place, beautiful ceremony, and just great to be a part of history yesterday here on High Top Sports Network. Of course, after this game, if you missed that one, we have all of our broadcasts from the past ready and available online. And so just visit our website, click the view all broadcasts, and search for what you want to watch. We got it all. Over 170 broadcasts that we've done since last year. And many more to come, of course. But it will be the Wolverines here starting with the opening serve. As soon as we get the officials' whistle to get things started, a little conversation between the officiating crew and both sides of the court before the match. And the first serve is underway. That one received by Polka. Now sent across, and the kill that time will be credited to Lacey Sopranos as the Cavaliers get on the board first here in set number two. Opening up the serving for the Cavaliers here in set number two will be Sydney Joyce as she readies to approach the service line, and she gets that one across, received by Boyd, popped up by Williams, and then sent across by Burnham. Just a little too much mustard on that hot dog as that one soars out of play. So the Cavaliers with another point. Once again, Madeline Joyce back to serve, or Sydney Joyce, excuse me. Joyce's serve across, once again, received by Boyd, set by Williams, and then hit across by Burnham. Popped up by Williams. Burnham with the kill there, diving to try and make the play defensively, was Lacey Sopranos. And now the Wolverines with their first point of the second set. That'll send Alana Williams, the senior, to serve. She gets that across, set there by Sydney Joyce, and then pushed across by Kuhn. Popped up by Boyd, and then the kill by Sunrise Myeras. Now we got a tie game. This one similar to the first set before Bryn Hewitt took to the service line and rallied off, I believe it was 12 straight points for the Cavaliers. That one received that time by Sopranos. And the kill, a rocket shot that time from Kate Wigton. Diving and trying to make the play, I believe that was Sarah Bauer for the Wolverines, but that ball hit so hard, if it would have made contact with the court, that one might have ended up in the center of the earth. And speaking of Bryn Hewitt, she will now be serving. And hit across, or just barely edged over the net there by Ondish. Set by Joyce. And the block in front, combining for it on that play, was Myeras and Burnham. And we're back at a tie game, 3-3, as Madeline Joyce subs in here for Carly Kuhn. Also coming in was Madeline Polka. Joyce with the set, and that one hammered over by Ondish, set by Williams, and hit across that time by Myeras. The front wall of Kiski Area trying to block that one, but it gets wedged in between them and the net there as Burnham serves. Diving for the play, trying to dig that one out, was Madeline Polka, but unable to do so. And this is the exact score that we had in the last game, 5-3, before Kiski went on that 12-0 run. It'll be Burnham serving now. That one goes into the net. So a substitution coming on. Madeline Polka checking out. Abigail Johns coming in. And we'll also have Beck for Wigton. And that'll send Beck to the service line here for the Cavaliers. Beck with the serve, received by Bauer, popped up by Williams, and a free ball sent over by Myeras. Set there, Joyce to Johns, that bounces off the front row of the Wolverines and falls to the court for another Cavaliers point. as we're tied back up here at 5-all. Emma Beck, the senior defensive specialist, serves this one. Received by Bauer. Popped up by Williams, and a free ball sent over there by Dondo. Johns with the hit. That one, I think, snuck in. They're going to give it to the Cavaliers. What a great job that time by Abigail Johns. Finding that far side corner for the point. And that'll send Emma Beck back to the service line. Beck gets that one across. Williams trying to tip that one over, blocked in front, then sent across by Ondish. Madeline Joyce pops it up, and that one blocked by the net on the kill attempt from Isabella Ondish. So we're back to a tie game after two or three straight Kiski area points. So not quite going the same way as the first set for Kiski whenever they were down 5-3, but we're back tied at 6-6. Burnham with the serve, popped up by Sydney Joyce, and that one mishit by Mayerez, so Kiski will now have the ball back. And a substitution coming on here as Macy Hepler checks in for Alyssa Wigand. And it'll be Macy Hepler back to serve. Hepler serve across, Boyd receives, and a free ball sent over by Boyd. Sydney Joyce to Madeline Joyce, or Madeline Joyce to Sydney Joyce, rather. And that one soars out of bounds on the kill attempt by Dondo. So the Cavaliers now with a 2-point lead as Hepler will head back to the service line, the senior. Hepler serve across, but that one out of bounds on the far sideline. So the Wolverines hanging tight here, down one, as the freshman, Sarah Bauer, is back to serve. Bauer hits that one out of bounds on the far sideline. So these two teams trading points on the service errors, both on the outside of the court, outside side of the court. Lacey Sofranos, the junior, will now serve it up here for the Cavaliers. She gets that one across, received by Bauer, set up by Williams, and that's going to be three hits, but I think that Kiski touched the net there. They are going to call the net violation on the Cavaliers. So the Wolverines dodging a bullet there. They'll get the serve back here. And that'll be Elena Dondo back to serve. Dondo with the rocket shot there, popped up by Sydney Joyce and then sent across. Williams with the push. Beck setting up Johns. She'll just finesse this one over, and that one's staying alive. Great play there by the Wolverines, pushed across that time by Sydney Joyce, and that is just high volleyball IQ there, showed off by Joyce. As she finds the weak spot in the defense, and now Beck checking out, as well as Johns coming on is Polka, and I believe that was Wigton checking in, if I'm not mistaken. Polka serve, goes across, received, kept alive by the Wolverines, and that ball finding a way to get down on the court for the Wolverines. Great effort that time by Woodland Hills to get that ball across. And now a substitution for the visitors, as subbing out is Helen DeCrosta, and coming back in is Sunrise Mayerez. The serve for the Wolverines is across. Joyce with the set and a push there by Carly Kuhn, and Carly Kuhn finding the weak spot in the defense there that time for the Cavaliers. And that'll send Sydney Joyce back to the service line. as coming off the court now is Macy Hepler for the Cavaliers. 2-point lead now for Kiski. As Joyce's serve, a cross received there by Boyd, popped up by Burnham, and then sent across by Myers. Set by Joyce, and absolutely crushed there by Kate Wigton. Wigton taking the set from Sydney Joyce and just hammering it home. And Sydney Joyce to serve again. That one received by Bauer. And tipped over by Myers. Quick set by Joyce. Getting it across is Carly Kuhn. Good dig there by Sofranos. And hit across there by Cora Coleman. Williams gets that one to Burnham. And a joust in front, won by Sunrise Myers. So a 2-point Kiski lead as heading back to serve will be Alana Williams. Williams' serve across. That time rolling off the fingertips of Sofrano. So just a 1-point deficit now for the Wolverines. So they're sticking around in this set. It was a long run by Kiski Area that kind of put the game out of reach in set number one, but the Wolverines competing here in set number two as Williams' serve goes across. That one received by Sofranos, popped up by Joyce, and then hit over by Coleman for the point. And now that'll set up the serve for Kiski as that skims across the top of the net on the serve by Hewitt. That ball's still alive. Dug out there by Hewitt. And hit across. Did she find it? She did. That one is going to be in. And that would be Kate Wigton with the kill there for the Cavaliers. And once again, it'll be Bryn Hewitt back to serve. Her excellence from the service line in set number one really set the Cavaliers ahead. So she's going to try to do that again. Great job and great awareness by Sydney Joyce to push that ball over. Kept alive by Polka, but nobody there to play that ball as it falls to the court for a Wolverines point. Back to serve now, Cynthia Burnham. For the Wolverines. Burnham serve across. That one popped up and going in the wrong direction. Hewitt giving chase to that one, but unable to get there in time as Woodland Hills gets another point there. Now they trail by just one. Burnham once again to serve. Set there by Sydney Joyce. Tipped across, but out of bounds. All tied up here at 14 all. Cynthia Burnham will be back to serve. The referees tonight, John Snyder and Juliana Casey. Burnham with the serve, received there by Madeline Joyce, popped up by Sydney Joyce. And then that time just Bondish couldn't get enough elevation under that ball as it goes into the net. So their first lead for a while here as the Wolverines jump ahead. Burnham back again to serve. Burnham serve across, received there by Ondish, set by Joyce, and blocked in front by Myers on the kill attempt by from Wigton. So now a 2-point Woodland Hills lead. Cynthia Burnham. Once again to serve. Received there by Madeline Joyce, popped up by Sydney Joyce, and then absolutely hammered off a deflection they're gonna call it that time. I believe that was Ondish that just crushed that one. It was either Ondish or Coleman, but either way, that ball absolutely smoked. And that'll send Emma Beck, the senior defensive specialist, back to the service line. Beck's serve across, that time received by Kayla Walter. And a good kill that time from Elena Dondo, as Woodland Hills now back up with a 2-point lead. That'll send Sunrise Mayerez to the service line. Carly Kuhn checking in here for Bryn Hewitt. Carly Kuhn also coming off the floor for Madeline Joyce, the libero. Mayerez's serve returned right back on the first hit. Williams setting up Bauer there, received by Beck. Joyce is set that time to Coleman, I believe, or rather Ondish. Now from the middle row, hitting that one across is Madeline Joyce. That one will go out of bounds, but a good rally there by the Wolverines, and you could tell they wanted that point. The libero and senior Nessa Boyd jumping up and down after that point. Her and her team really wanted that one, but it'll go to Kiski Area, and now back to serve for Coleman. Coleman gets that across. Free ball incoming for Kiski. Kept alive, just having to push that one across is Johns. Boyd setting that one up. Back row hit received there by Beck. Popped up by Joyce and then sent across by Cora Coleman. Boyd popping this one up again. That one smacked over. Sydney Joyce. That one deflected back. And a great effort there from the front row. Elena Dondo getting the block on the play. And the Wolverines holding on to that 2-point lead. Going back and forth between a 1-point lead for these Wolverines and a 2-point lead. They're staying strong here in set number two as back to serve is Sarah Bauer. That serve into the net. So now just a 1-point deficit here for Woodland Hills. Couple substitutions coming on here for the home Cavaliers. And back to serve, it'll be Lacey Sopranos. Sopranos' serve, received by Boyd. That one popped up. And a free ball sent over there by Dondo. Joyce with the set. Boyd receives. Back row, Beck. Popped up by Coleman and then pushed over by Sopranos. Three ball sent over. Coleman to Joyce. Up to Johns. That one deflected off the front row. So the Cavaliers will pick up the point. And now we're all tied up again at 18. The line judge, Chloe Weishens going up in the stands to grab that one. Back underway. Yes, that one is short. It's back and forth we go. Woodland Hills with the lead and the serve coming up here. Heading to the service line, Elena Dondo, the freshman. Dondo serve across, that one received by Beck, and then just a free ball played over by Sydney Joyce. Williams up to Barnum. Joyce setting up John, she tips it over. That ball hit a couple of times, but just catching the defense off guard. Where are the Cavaliers on that point? And now it'll be Abigail Johns' serve. Johns' serve, kind of like a knuckleball, just sinking immediately, diving for it on the play was Nessa Boyd, but that ball dropped immediately once it got over the net. Great serve there by the sophomore outside hitter, Abigail Johns. Johns with another serve, that one dropping as well, diving to make the play that time was Elena Dondo, and that'll force a Woodland Hills timeout. And so while we have a moment, we'll take a timeout too, hear from some of our great sponsors on High Top Sports Network. I'm Jake DeLuca. We'll be right back after this quick break.
Gross Embroidery and Sign Shop is the official clother of High Top Sports Network and is a family-owned company that can handle all your custom embroidery, custom sign, and laser engraving needs. Located at 409 4th Street in downtown Fort City, Gross Embroidery and Sign Shop can create sports and career apparel to the exact specifications of your organization. Their laser engraving department can put your logo or design on glasses, tumblers, insulated cups, signs, coffee cups, and more. Call Gross Embroidery and Sign Shop at 724-763-2461 today.
And welcome back, everyone, to High Top Sports Network. Kiski Area up 21-19 in set number two after taking set number one by a wide margin. This one a little tighter. Boyd receives that serve. Blocked in front there by Carly Kuhn. And the bench erupts in a synchronized Kuhn. Kind of reminds you of Heath Miller. You know, whenever Heath would make a catch for the Steelers, reminiscent of that here at Kiski Area. And just dropping that serve in once again was Abigail John. She's been doing an excellent job here from the service line at the end of this set. Really putting Kiski in the driver's seat after these two teams exchanged leads and ties. John's once again to serve. Hit across, received by the Cavaliers, set up by Joyce. That one to Johns, off the deflection, and now we're at set point. Johns with the chance to ice this game out from the service line. Johns with the serve. That one skimming over the net, nearly caught the defense off guard, but great awareness there by Cynthia Burnham. Two players collide into each other for the Cavaliers. That one tipped over and game, or set point rather, scored that time by Kate Wigton as the Cavaliers escape with the victory in set number two to go up 2-0. I mentioned before the JV swept Woodland Hills for Kiski here, 2-0. I'm sure that the varsity team would like to do the same and get five straight set wins here tonight for the Cavaliers. But we got about 5 minutes to go, so 5 minutes to go until the start of the third set. And I'm about out of water, so I'm going to go and remedy that situation real quick. Get myself some more water to stay hydrated here up in the booth. And I also believe now is time for the Rubber Ducky 50-50, the most interesting and unique 50-50 in all of sports in my mind. Without a doubt, I will go out there on a limb and say most unique and my favorite 50-50. And you know what? We got to give you a good zoom on this. So I'm going to zoom in, grab a water, and I'll be right back for the start of the third set.
I'm going to go to the hospital. 96 is the winner of the rubber duck contest.
And I made it back without a second to spare here. Ready for set number three, the potential game-ending set here, unless the Wolverines can squeak out a win here in set number three. They looked like they were getting a lot more comfortable out there in set number two, a lot closer than set number one. But the Cavaliers up two sets to none now. Coleman with the set, and that one sent over by Johns, but a little too much on the bump over the net by Abigail Johns, and that'll give the Wolverines the serve now. Wolverine serve across. That one received by Polka, set up by Joyce, and then just lofted over by Kuhn. Burnham with the kill. Nice dig there by Carly Kuhn. And that one finding the back row in the empty zone for Cora Coleman as she gets the point. And now substitution coming on. Checking out will be Kate Wigton. And coming in, I believe that was Isabella Ondish. Indeed, it was Isabella Ondish. Trying to see the jersey number to confirm. Now it'll be Madeline Joyce with the serve. Boyd pops this one way up, and that's hit across by Mayeras. Joyce to Joyce connection, and then just tipped over that time by Ondish. So a little trickery, a little trickeration there by Ondish, just tapping that ball across. And that'll give the Cavaliers the early 2-1 lead as Madeline Joyce, the freshman libero, heads to the service line. And that one, just a miscommunication down on the floor for the Wolverines. And once again, Madeline Joyce to serve. Joyce's serve across that time, a little over the line. So the Wolverines will get the ball back here and tracking to the service line. Will be Alana Williams. Williams' serve across, received there by Madeline Joyce to Sydney Joyce now. That popped up to Carly Kuhn. And trying to dig that one out was Kayla Walter, but just hit too hard by Carly Kuhn. Beck checking in here as well as Abigail Johns. Or maybe Abigail Johns? Okay, so Abigail Johns coming on now for Madeline Polka. And that sends Emma Beck to the service line here for the Cavaliers. Beck serve across, received, and now Williams setting it up for Burnham. Great dig by Madeline Joyce there on the play to keep it alive. Hit across by Mayerez. Diving for the dig was Beck. That one hit across there by Abigail Johns. Great dig there by the Wolverines. Beck back row to receive that one. Joyce to Johns. Boyd right there to dig that one. Hit across by Mayerez. Pushed forward by Beck. Locked in front. Kept alive, though, by Cora Coleman. And then hit from the middle row by Madeline Joyce, rather. And it will be Kiski point after the infraction by the Wolverines. Emma Beck to serve. She hits it across. Boyd with the receive, popped up by Williams. Lifted across by Burnham. Tipped over that time by Ondish, and now back at it is Johns. She gets a little too much on that ball, sending it out of bounds. Woodland Hills trailing by just two now here in the third and potentially final set. Back to serve, Cynthia Burnham. Great job there by Sydney Joyce to kind of just do-si-do that ball across the net, but the Wolverines ready for it. That one out of bounds on the near sideline. They're going to give it to him. Well, that was the right call. They initially pointed to the Kiski area side, but it will be the Wolverines with the point. That one just out of bounds on the near sideline. Sydney Joyce setting it up to Abigail Johns, and she just located the sweet spot on the ball and found the weak spot in the defense. Abigail Johns has had a number of those great kills, and of course she was the one that brought it home in the second set in that close game, not only from the service line, but coming up to the front row to get the set-winning point. So Abigail Johns having a heck of a game here today. That'll be Bryn Hewitt with the serve. She was instrumental in set number one, helped Kiski area on a 12-0 run from the service line, and she gets them another point there, does Hewitt, as she tracks back to the service line. Hewitt serve across, poked over by Williams. Joyce trying to dunk that one on the other side. She does so successfully after a couple of hits on the other end. Kiski area now doubled up over Woodland Hills, up 8-4. Hewitt serve across once more and dunked down by Isabella Ondish. So Hewitt, maybe another run from the service line, similar to the one she went on in the first set. Put together a few nice looking serves and really a team effort here for those points. Diving for the floor, but not able to get there in time was Madeline Joyce, as a little commentator's curse creeps in there. Substitution. Now Kayla Walter checking out, and it'll send Sunrise Mayerez to the service line here as her team trails by four. Mayerez a serve across. Beck able to dig that one out on the receive. Hewitt pops that one across. Williams with the set. Pushed. Diving play there by Madeline Joyce. Abigail Johns trying to get it across, but A great block on the combined efforts of Elena Dondo and Sarah Bauer as the Wolverines trail by just three now. Once again, Mayerez back to serve. That serve, a lot of power on that, but just too much as it sails out of bounds on the backside boundary. Checking in for the Cavaliers is Sofranos as she goes to the service line, subbing in for Isabella Ondish. And that one deflecting off the player on the back row there. I believe that was Elena Dondo. So the Cavaliers now with a 5-point lead. That one hit over too hard there as that goes out of bounds. It was a little close there, but the referees converge, give each other a good old nod and confirm the point for the Wolverines. As now it'll be Sarah Bauer from the service line. That one looked like it had a chance to squeeze over top of the net, but it'll be stopped in its tracks. Just hit off the top of the net. You see a lot of those where it'll hit the top, the white part above the netting, and kind of roll over. That ball definitely had potential to do so, but the net had other plans, as now Abigail Johns is back to serve. That one, just a beauty as it lands behind the back row, right in front of that backside boundary. Now a 6-point lead for the Cavaliers. Abigail Johns getting it done all over the court today. Really impressed with her serving tonight. She's just been able to drop these serves right in the weak spot of the defense. And there's another example. They just kind of drop on you. You don't expect them to just go over the net and immediately have a downward trajectory. But Abigail Johns consistently hitting those serves like a nice sinker in baseball. Johns with another serve. That one received by Mayerez. Stuffed in front that time. A great block by Kate Wigton. Great anticipation on the front row from the junior, Kate Wigton, out there as the middle blocker here for the Cavaliers, and that will force a timeout on the visitor sideline while we have a moment here. High Top Sports Network is excited to broadcast Kiski Athletics, Kiski Area Athletics this fall. If you or someone you know is a local business owner interested in sponsoring HTSN's coverage of Cavaliers Athletics, now or in the future, please contact us at staff@hightopsportsnetwork.com, or you can give us a call at 724-824-3554. You can also find us at hightopsportsnetwork.com. Make sure to follow us on social media, on Facebook, just search High Top Sports. And on Twitter @hightop_sports. It's a great way to keep up with where we're going to be night by night, as well as some other excellent content from the High Top guys. So make sure you follow us on social media to keep up to date with all the happenings on HTSN as we break from timeout. And Johns with the serve. That one just a little too hard as it goes out of bounds. Wolverines wisely laying off of that one. And that'll send Elena Dondo, the freshman, back to the service line. Dondo's serve, just a moonshot out of bounds. So Kiski back with the serve. Now an 8-point lead. And that'll send Sydney Joyce, the junior setter for the Cavaliers, to the service line. Joyce's serve across, that one received by Dondo. Hammered across, back row, able to get there was Polka. Hit over that time by Sofranos, kept alive by the Wolverines. Another one hammered across by the outside hitter for Woodland Hills as they take the point here. And now back to serve. Polka able to receive that one. That one hit back row by Sofranos. Players for the Wolverines colliding, diving for the ball. As that one is hit out of bounds on the Wolverine sideline. So it will be a point here for Kiski Area as Madeline Joyce checks into the game here for Wigton. Also coming on is Isabella Ondish for Lacey Sofranos. Madeline Joyce back to serve now for the home team. Boyd diving to receive that serve, but just another one of those serves that goes over the net and kind of sinks down to the court in a fast manner. Joyce with the serve again, gets that across. Pushed right back over by Ondish. Williams with the set, Burnham. Great dig that time by Sydney Joyce, but it will go into the net for a Wolverines point. And back to serve, it'll be Alana Williams. 8-point lead here for the Cavaliers. Williams a serve, gets across. Diving for the play was Madeline Joyce. Great effort there by the Cavaliers. Joyce pops that one up to Sydney Joyce. And then hit down by Carly Kuhn for the Cavaliers point. 9-point lead as Carly Kuhn checks out and Emma Beck comes on to serve. Also coming on, Abigail Johns for Madeline Polka. Emma Beck with the serve. Williams pushes that one across. Beck back deep to receive. Hammered that time by Ondish. Great dig by Boyd. And that ball hit out of bounds on the far sideline by the Wolverines. That gives Kiski Area the point and sends Beck, Emma Beck, back to the service line. That one received by Bauer. Hit across by Boyd. Beck gets it on the other side. And then blocked down emphatically by Cynthia Burnham. And back to serve now, number 28, Cynthia Burnham, the junior here for the Wolverines. That serve received by Emma Beck, popped up by Sydney Joyce, and then unable to get it over that time on the hit by Alyssa Wiegand, as the Wolverines trying to claw their way back into this one. They will not go silently here. Really put up a great fight there in set number two. At points, it looked like they had the advantage, but Kiski able to close it out. Cavaliers this time with a big lead. And they're going to call that one inbounds for Kiski Area. That one dancing with the far sideline, but the judges confirm that it is, in fact, a Kiski point. And that'll send Bryn Hewitt into the game, coming on for Wiegand. And Hewitt back to the service line. Hewitt serve, received that time by Mayerez. Dug out by Hewitt, set by Joyce to Johns. And that one sneaking in, same place as the last point that snuck in on that far sideline. Kiski now 3 points away from taking set number three and the game on their way to a 2-0 section record here to start the season. A loss here would drop the Wolverines to 0-2 in section play. Johns trying to steal a point right there. She keeps it alive, but this one going towards the crowd or towards the Kiski Area sideline. So the Wolverines will get the point there. And that'll send Sunrise Mayerez to the service line for the visiting team. Mayerez serves it, Beck receives, set there by Sydney Joyce. Williams with the set, hit over that time by Dondo. Going up with some power with it that time was Isabella Ondish as she gets the point. Madeline Joyce checks out. Coming back onto the court is Kate Wigton. Also checking in is Lacey Sopranos coming on for Ondish. Ondish getting a big round of applause and high fives all around from her teammates after that last kill. Joyce bounces that one up to Johns. Williams able to dig that one out and keep it alive. And then pushed over. Johns receives. Joyce with the set. Hit from the mid row that time from Hepler. And double hit that time called on the Wolverines. That'll send Lacey Sopranos to the service line here for the potential match point. Boyd receives, Williams with the set. And just miscommunication there, and that's how it'll end. So the Cavaliers take three straight sets. Very impressive play here. Bouncing back after their non-section game yesterday against Norwin in the first ever high school, official high school game on a grass court. Of course, that was a beautiful memorial for Ellen Toy. The Ellen Toy grass court out at Kennedy Park. Check it out sometime if you're a fan of volleyball. There's nets up there. You can get your volley on. But that'll do it here for me tonight on High Top Sports Network. Thank you all so much for listening. And I want to thank those of you who have chosen to donate. Clicking that green donation button really helps us out here on HTSN. So thank you all for watching, listening, however you may be enjoying this broadcast. And until next time, we'll see you later. If you're curious about our schedule, we have a lot of our games posted on our website. Just go to the More tab, and you can kind of see what we got going on. So until next time, I've been Jake DeLuca. Thank you all so much for tuning into High Top Sports Network. We'll see you around.